Hello everyone, welcome back. So today topic is auto starting of induction motor pump after the power outage. So today's topic is specially designed for agriculture project. The title is written there, you can see, and it is a water pumping system with the auto timer switch that the farmer is required in nowadays. You can see this title also. So I have designed this simulation for the agriculture project that you can see in window also. So this is the MATLAB simulating software. You can design this project in this simulation, and this all ready-made component you can find in library browser. So go to the library browser in your MATLAB. So you can see the libraries are available in left hand side. So you can find various component of the electrical, electronics and drive lines also. You can see left hand side power system is there. So in that Simscape components are available for electrical simulation. So you can find motors also, and the devices also available in fundamental blocks. You can see electrical source are there. In elements you can find the breakers, supply, load and everything. So for that I have already taken from the library. These are the blocks are available in the library. So this blocks is pair into the thyristor, and this is the again pair of bus bars, and let the separate all the component and let starting the simulation of this software. So we need to connect each and every component for this simulation. So let us try to connect this. So this is the power supply. So I need to connect this power supply with the neutral, with the ground, and before this simulation we need to ready this power supply for the motor. So let us take input voltage measurement block and connect it with the A point, and one let me take the neutral for the ground so that I can measure the phase voltage from this block. So now let us take the RMS. This blocks convert average value to the RMS, so it can use for further controlling purpose, that can used in controller also signal process. So this is the gain block that connected with the RMS, so that converted into the unity input voltage, you can see there. And this is again the gain values, and these pairs are thyristor pair, and if we connect this thyristor to the power supply, so it can control the input voltage. So now let us connect this converter block with this gain value so that we can process the further signal of the RMS for the controlling purpose, which is coming from input voltage. You can see the block RMS and voltage measurement. And now these gain values are important to make this unity signals, and we can further process of the delay using these blocks. And these are the scope and the display. So in this most important, this is the two thyristors are there. So let me connect these two thyristor with the power supply, and voltage again is connected back with the input voltage, and the motor connection should be also with the A phase. So between power source, the T1 and the T2 thyristor is connected. So the both terminal gate should be connected. So let us make this thyristor anti-parallel. So I need to rotate this block. So I have rotated this and connected with the T2 thyristor. So bunch of these two will make the triax, we know that. So now we can connect this two gate terminal with the T1 and T2. So you can apply the gate pulse to both of them component at a time, same time. Now trying to connect this gate terminal. So let me take this one and this one here. So this is the bunch of thyristors. So the function of two thyristor, it is working as a triac. You can see in figure also that how it going to control the input voltage and the output voltage. You can see in image also that, and this is a physical layout of the thyristor that can control the AC voltage to the output voltage. So it is very much important for the controlling. So now coming back to the circuit here. So this is the simulation connection. So let us continue our connection for the controlling. So we have connected the motor power supply. So let us take the bus selector for the measurement of AC synchronous motor, sorry, induction motor. So this is the mechanical rotor speed. You can get these values from this left hand side block, whatever you want, the rotor resistance, rotor current, anything you want. Now we have taken the rotor speed, so that we need to convert this RPS rotor speed to the RPM according to the Indian standard. So now I have connected the display with this RPM gain, and this is the delay block that must be connected with the transport delay for creating the delay signals which is coming from the input voltage. Now this is the display, so let me take away, and you can connect this slider gain in between. You can provide the convert block that is used to convert the signals into the boolean signal, otherwise MATLAB will show the error. So you need to compulsory connect this in this manner. Now let me connect this connection with the MOX, the one of unity input voltage, and second should be connected from the, let me take delay supplies which is coming from the RMS block, so we can easily compare the input voltage and converted RMS signal from the input, so we can also measure the outage which is happened into the power supply. So second it is connected with the transport delay, and this line is coming from the input voltage. You can see the RMS block and the transport delay, so you can connect at this point whatever you wanted to see in signal port. So this control transport delay is specially due to design for creating the delay of the signal that happened of power outage. So you can see here the signals port are there, so third one should be connected with the motor output voltage. So we will take one another MUX line, so that is connected with the RPM, and second thing we need to connect with the transport delay, and the output is connected with the signal port here. So I will connect the speed, and the motor output voltage is connected at the terminal voltage, so we will require one ground, so I will take from here. So you can copy this, let me rotate this and connect it with negative of voltage, and again for the motor also neutral is grounded. So now this remain is gate only, so gate should be connected of the transport delay here. So this circuit is goes to the gate pulse of the both switch, you can see in green line transport delay. These two thyristors are connected with the transport delay gate, and this delay block is specially for the showing the values of whatever we apply the delay through this slider gain. So let me increase the font of this block, so taking this 72 size, now it is very much clear and visible. So let me take in right hand side. So this is the delay, it should be connected with the slider gain, so that we can see in display also that how much we have provided delay to the our thyristor, so that our simulation is going to work. So this is the complete connections of our simulation. So let me show you the parameters of input voltage. So this is 440 voltage and 50 hertz according to Indian standard, and you can see the voltage variations are there, amplitude and the time values. So there is a three zeros are there, and you can see three zeros are according to this time values up to the 0.17 second. So it means it will show the zero output voltage, and after this it will be work as a healthy circuit for the 0.45 second. So first three it is power outage. You can see the time values also. You can design your own outage by using the different values, and let me show you the motor parameter also. This is the parameters. This is the default. You can change this also according to your load applications. These are the parameters I have used in this simulation, and this is the transport delay. So you see the maximum delay also, and let the motor output voltage is connected with this multiplier. So removing the transport delay and connected with the motor voltage, so that we can see also the how the terminal voltage it's happened after the power outage and how it is goes to the motor load. So this is important block also. So now let us start this simulation, running the simulation. It's just taking some time. So you see the display is showing now 0.7327, that is a delay time into the second, and all the signals of the thyristor and supplies are available into the signal port, that we can understand that how it's going to work. So let me open this signal port, just taking some time. The simulation is complex, so that simulation is slow somehow, so you can wait until it get opened. So it is opened now. So see here, the signals are available. The red line shows the input voltage, and the before this black line, it is a RMS values of these signals. So here you can see the AC voltage is in red line, the legends are so here, and the second graph for black line, that is a delay signal you can see, and this is the power outage area. So in this area the power is goes off, and after this point the voltage is available. You can see at this point voltage is available, and we have set our delay up to the 0.7327. so you see here in second graph also, so this is the delay signals, and the last graph green signal shows the input voltage back with our timer, and the red line shows the motor speed which we have connected with the power supply. So ultimately you can get the 1500 rpm of the motor at desired set point of the delay. So let me change the values of delay using the slider gain which we have connected with the transport delay. So see here, this is the delay block, changing the limits of delay. So now it is made 0.34. now running the simulation, you see it must change the delay operation of motor. So now new value is 0.341. so you can compare the previous case with this also. So it is somehow forwarded to the left side. It means motor is started earlier before the previous case compare with this. So it was started was somewhere 0.7 here, but now it is started here. So you can see these values also, and the input voltage is available, RPM is also available, motor is started somehow faster than previous case. So now changing again, making the faster than this. So running this simulation, so now new values are set up to 0.11 now, and you can also compare this data. This is the power outage, and you can see this point is important for us. So after the small gap of this point, you can see the motor is started very much earlier compared with the previous cases. So this is the RPM of motor. You can see red line shows the RPM, and again I'm changing the values. I'm increasing the delay of power outage, so it will start after some time. So now new delay is 0.7373, you can see, and you can see in waveform also, again changing the new delay. So So it is made 0.93. So my motor is started after the some maximum distance. So this is all about the auto starting of the power outage for the agriculture project. So this is the control, so you can develop this project into the controller of Arduino with the cheap cost also, and the program is very easy. So this is all about the project. Thank you very much, all of you.